Sometimes we need to create more complex macros. We will make an example in this workbook, Combine Macros, and in London worksheet. We would like to copy these cells and paste them as columns. Transpose them to columns, in other words. To make complex macros, it's better to record some of the code we need, check it out a little bit, and then add to it. So we will do it step by step. Starting from cell A1, we will start recording as absolute reference first. The copy and paste of the cells will be with the relative reference recording mode on. First of all, we will record an empty macro to create a module. Click that button, press OK, and stop recording. Open the VBA editor, and as you can see, there is a module there. Double-click it, and there is no actual code in it. Delete these lines, and arrange the Excel and editor windows. So you can see all of them at once. Make sure that absolute reference is on and start recording. Give the macro a name, like Transpose. And as keyboard shortcut, press Ctrl, Shift and T. Store the macro in this workbook and press OK. Highlight B2 shell and see the code. Now it's time to turn the relative reference on. From the View tab, click the down arrow and relative reference. Copy these cells . Go to D2, right-click, paste special, click transpose and OK. Look at the VBA code and you can notice the copy, the paste special and the transpose selection. The next step is to do exactly the same procedure for the next three cells. Copy, right-click, paste special, click transpose and OK. One more time. And we are ready. Stop the macro. If you look the code carefully, you will see a pattern, a repetition with almost the same code lines, except the first date, of course, which was the selection of three cells and the first three cells that we highlighted. Let's read the code. We highlight and copy the three cells. We select D cell, then paste special, transpose and OK, and so on. Keep in mind that rates A1 to A3 does not mean the specific cells. It means that we highlight three cells. Now that we understand the pattern, we need to get rid of the repetition code and we'll keep only one set of these. So highlight these and delete. We want to do these actions over and over again. The best choice is do until loop. Start typing do until it's empty. Open parenthesis, active cell, close parenthesis. This line means do these actions until the active cell is empty. Add the loop statement before end stop and you are ready. The final step is to run this macro. You can do this with two different methods. The one is to run the macro immediately and the other is to go step by step. Let's follow the second method. Arrange the two windows and from debug, select step window or F8. Pressing F8 and you will see all the steps one by one. F8 again and seems to work great. As a final note, you will delete the blank cells. Select these columns And from Home Ribbon, press Find and select Button. From Go to Special Option, choose Blanks and OK. Now right-click, Delete and Shift Cells Up. The basic idea from this lecture is that when we have complex macros, we need to break the macro into small pieces and test it over and over to make sure it finally works fine. Thank you!